Welcome to Admister Studios. This is video number 4. Now in this video, let me show you first what we did in the last video, video number 3. So I hope you must have practiced the code for the last 2-3 videos I have uploaded to GitHub already. You'll find the link in the post which I did. I will share the URL as well. Okay, but let me show you how I did that. Okay, starting with the about component. In the about component, we got title, description, detail, icon blocks. Okay, these icon blocks we used a for loop to repeatedly do this. And in the component section, I have all the data available. So if you look at this, this is my variable which contains this object, and this object has some title, description, detail, button, and these are the icon blocks. Similarly, we'll go to the next one. In the client section, we got this one as the data. I have the image path, the name, and I have given some IDs. This is some random text. I picked it from the template itself. I have not added anything. And then similarly, in the HTML template for clients, we added the title, we added description, detail, company name, and all these things. And all this code is available for you to check on the GitHub. Let me show you the footer also. Footer, I have not done any changes as yet. Okay, but I wish to change this to a component, which we'll do it in this video quickly. Footer, then in the gallery, let me show you the gallery structure. Now this is how the gallery is. Now coming on to header, this is the header component. Now, if you look at it, what we are trying, we did is that we separated data from the template, but we are keeping this data still in the components transcript file, TypeScript file. So my next step would be to change it from here. Okay, let me show you the pricing one. Now in the pricing section, you will see there are so many parameters. I even change the currency symbol, the price, this is number. And then there is something called featured, false, true, true. So let me show you. If I go to this page here and let's go to pricing, you'll find the middle one is highlighted. So this is a featured class. Let's change this to featured. Okay, so if I change this to true and save this, you'll find that color of this block also has changed. So this is what we did with featured, and how we implemented this, it is quite simple. Let me show the HTML. In the HTML section, wherever we want to apply a class, let's say class.featured is what I want to apply, and the criteria here is that pricing block.featured value should be, I'm a little sleepy, ignore. Okay, class.featured. So it's calculate what the value is. If it is true, then it will apply this class. Okay, feel free to do some experimenting and be a little bit more creative. Now, only thing, now what we want to do is let's combine all this data together, and this is what happens in an application. You can actually keep it, okay, you can actually keep it separate, we can do that, but you can also keep it at one place. So in a typical application, what happens is the data comes from some remote server, which definitely we are going to implement here also. But for the time being, for the mocking activity, when you become a developer, Angular developer, the most important thing is to showcase how the application front end would work, and that too primarily with the dummy data. And then later on, the actual data can be plugged in. So similarly, we have got testimonial also. Now what I'm going to do is let's create a new service. So in the app folder, let's create a new folder called services. So this is how I generally organize services together. So we'll go to command prompt. Oh, sorry, let me open command prompt. I will go to D drive and then to website. this website we'll create ng generate service, and let's give the pass services slash, oh, let's call it config, simple config service. So ng generate service services config. So we are going to generate the services here. While it is generating, let's create a component also. Let's change the social icons into a component. Okay. Another task that we want to do is, I want to show you something called interfaces. If you don't know what interfaces is, in JavaScript, we do not have, there is no hard and fast rule for type accuracy. But when you're using TypeScript, you need to have much more accuracy, and the purpose of TypeScript is to ensure the correct type data types are mentioned. Now here our data is in different format. Okay, testimonials, we have some common blocks, common properties, but again these are different. So how to go about making these changes? So let's try to simplify it together in one single file. So our service file is created. Okay, now we are going to club all this data together at one place. I'm not going to remove this data as of now from individual component. I'll just copy it here from here to the other file. So let's go to config service.ts. Okay, and let's declare our variable here. So let me call this variable configuration. Now configuration I have mentioned, but what is the type of this configuration? How would I know the type? So let's first, we don't know the type yet, so let's do it normally. Okay, I'll copy everything from these components step by step. So let's go to the about component first. From the TS file, let's copy this data. Okay, what we need is an array. So these all would be like pages. So it's a, okay, let's do it like this. Let's call this data, and this is name of the page. Name of the page is about. Let's give it an ID also, ID 1. So we have ID, the name is about, data is this. From this to this is the data. And let's, okay. Now this becomes one object. And similarly, we'll add other objects. So about. So if you look at it, I have made a change. ID is there, name is something that I have added, and this is how we'll identify the page number, name of the page. And this data is specific to the about page. Now let's do it for the next one. I'll go to clients. In the client components, let's copy this. Okay, back to the config service. And I'll create a curly bracket and then paste. Client will be the name. This will be data. And let's do the ID. ID is 2. So ID number 2, name is client, and this is the data for client. Okay. this is done. Let's go to the next one. Next one is footer. Okay, we'll go to footer later. Let's go to gallery. So let's copy this. Name is gallery, ID is 3. Okay, ID is 3, gallery is the name, and this is the data. Okay. So now, if you look at it, I have consistently made the name and nomenclature as company blocks, icon blocks. Okay, let's maintain the consistency, icon blocks, and let's call this gallery blocks. Okay, I think it looks good to me. Now comma, again another bracket. Now let's go to header. Now you got the idea what I'm trying to do, right? So I'll just quickly do this. Data name, comma, ID 4, comma. So this is also done, comma. Okay, let me pause this video and I will quickly paste, complete this. Okay, Control Shift. What was the shortcut? Okay, so let's look at it. I have made changes. ID 1. Okay, how to create full? Okay, now I have populated the entire set of data from all the components. Let's look at it quickly. About, client, and it's a common structure, ID, name, and then data. ID, name, data. ID, name, data. ID, name, data. And similarly, we got ID, name, services, testimonial. And footer also, I have made some data points. I'll make the changes in the footer. We have not yet separated this data, but we'll do this. And for social media icon, let's create this component. So it's a different component with the name ID social. And let's first create this. So our data is here at one place. We'll create the component, so we don't have to worry. Now, I was talking to you about the interfaces. Now, interface is kind of declaring a type of data hierarchy. Now, with this data in one place, we can draw hierarchy. Okay, let's create an interface. So we'll go back to our component and we'll call ng generate interface, and name of the interface would be config item, configuration item. Okay, so configuration item is created. Let's open this file. Where is the config item? Okay, let's move it to within the services folder. So I'm moving this interface to within services folder. And this is the configuration item. Okay, let's open this configuration service.ts. Sorry, configuration item.ts. Now this is a simple interface class. What we'll do is we'll move our configuration item definition. So what is the format and structure of this configuration item? So let's do this. Okay, what you have to do is go to configuration, and here you have configuration. So configuration.configuration. So we'll go to configuration and then copy up till here. Company blocks, social blocks, will add one by one. Okay, let me find if there is a better way. Go to source definition. I'm not sure if this works, but let's do this. Configuration. So this is our configuration looks like as of now. Now we know that these data blocks are different. Okay, let's close this data block and I can remove this bracket. So this is done. Okay, now let's open this config item file. In the config item file, we want to define the structure of our data. So here we have this configuration item and we want to specify only the structure. So let's copy this structure from here and it goes like this. I have ID and we got this. Okay, so we'll copy it here. So if you see, my data has ID, it has got name, it has got title, data, and this data. Okay, let me add one more. So this is data, but if you see, our data has so much of variation. We got icon blocks, then apart from icons block, we have company blocks. So let's copy company blocks. And then after company blocks, we got gallery blocks. So let's copy gallery blocks here. Similarly, we'll copy only the blocks we are talking about right now. We'll go to pricing block. Okay, then after pricing block, we have testimonial block, feedback block. So in the feedback block, we just copied the structure. So now these social blocks also, I have not yet implemented this, but we'll do it now. Okay, we're pretty much done. Now I am saying that in the structure of the data I'm expecting in the configuration item, we can have ID, we can have name, we can have title, description, detail, button text, social icons. And I'm saying this type, okay, all the sections have title, description, detail, but button text is not always there. Title, description, detail. We got title, description, detail, title, description, URL. So here URL is also there. So we'll go to copy this URL. And let's add it to our list. That URL can also be there. Apart from URL, we have title, description, detail. Title, description, detail, title, description, detail. We have here title, URL, developer. Okay. Developer is also there. So let's add developer as well. Okay. Do we have anything else? No. These are some of the things that we might get. So there is something called specific, this question mark symbol, that describes that property in a way that it may or may not be there. So we can use question mark with all our properties. So I'm also saying that icon blocks can cannot be there, company blocks may not be there, same for gallery, pricing block, feedback, and this one. Okay, so this I have saved. So I'm saying that this is one of my configuration item, and now in this service that we created, let's import this definition of configuration item. So import config item. So I have imported the config item, and I'm saying this configuration variable is of type config item, but it's an array. It's a configuration item array. So see, we do not have any errors. It has identified this data with no errors. Now let's close this for our easy understanding. So we defined a variable with all the data of the entire applications together in one single place called configuration. And now we will create functions. Functions that will help me fetch this data. Okay. So let's create two functions. Okay. So here we have config item. So I have created two functions after the constructor, get all pages. So all pages, it will give you return the entire data set. Configuration item, this dot configuration, it would return. Second, there is a function called get page by name. So what we are going to do is we are going to use this function. Let's say I'm going to use this from about page. We'll call and give parameters as about, and it will give me a value in return. Now if you look at it, what it is returning, it is returning that from this configuration find the configuration item. So one by one it will search through configuration item, and if configuration item dot name equals to page name, which is the parameter passed here, then give me that data. Okay, simple enough. Now let's do the implementation part. So we'll save this. And now we have to use this in the components that we have. So let's do this in components one by one. Okay. Okay. So let's do this. We'll go to, okay, we have already have testimonial open. So we'll start from here. So let's import both the files. So import configuration item and import configuration service. This is done. Now let's comment this piece of data as of now. We'll go here. Now here I want to declare a variable same with the same name, testimonials. So testimonials is of type configuration item. Config item. Okay, or it could be undefined. So I'm saying it could be defined or it could be undefined. Now this variable is not yet defined, so we know sure that it will return. So there is something called exclamation. So if you use exclamation, specify that this variable is not yet initialized, but we are sure that we'll get the value after the function is started. So now let's create a variable for configuration service. So we'll call it config service, which is of type config service is equal to inject config service. So inject, we will have to import from core. Inject config service. Okay, so this is what we need, and now we have our, now let's start our constructor. Constructor is the first function that gets executed when a class is called. So here we want to specify that this dot testimonials equals to this dot config service dot get pages by name, and will testimonials. Okay, what is the name? I think it is the same name which was there, testimonials. Yes, testimonials. Okay, so we're setting this variable testimonials equal this dot animal equal this dot config service. So okay, so this is what is gets done. Okay, now it's time to make the changes in the template. Why so? Because earlier, okay, let me do undo. Earlier the structure was like this: testimonial, we have access to testimonial dot title, testimonial dot description, testimonial dot details, testimonial dot feedbacks. But now in this new structure we have testimonials dot data dot title, testimonial dot data dot description dot data dot detail dot data dot feedback. So same we should be reflecting in the template. So let's go to template. So testimonials dot data dot title, testimonials dot data dot description, testimonials dot data dot feedbacks. Okay, let's check once more. We have testimonials. Okay, this is the correct spelling. Testimonials. Okay, it's giving an error. Why? Does not exist on type, title, undefined. Undefined detail. Okay. So I have defined this as undefined. And in the config service, here also we have defined it as undefined, because it could either return null or undefined, or it will return the configuration item. Get page by name, testimonial, this dot testimonials equals to this dot config service. Okay. Okay, so we made the changes to this testimonial file, and already well, let's get rid of that data. Now in the HTML, okay, now it is directly not able to validate that if data is going to be there or not. So let's define this as exclamation mark that it may or may not be there. So we get rid of the compilation error. Testimonials.data.feedbacks. This should work. Okay, let's go and check. If I refresh and I go to testimonial, I have the data visible to me. So this is working. Now let's make changes to this about section. So even with this error, it is still working, and it's not the error, it is just the compilation error. It shows that it may not be able to find this data. So testimonials is done. Now let's go to about. So we'll go to about section, and we will copy pretty much what we did here. Let's close these two, and in the about, replace this with, so I'll call it about, now we'll have to import, so import config item port config service and inject. Okay, now let's make changes to about dot data exclamation mark dot. So replacing okay, let's save this. So showing icon blocks does not exist on type, okay, because it is not capital, it is small I. Okay, let's refresh. So my about section is also working. We can close this. Let's copy. Okay, let's keep this open. Okay, now after about, we'll go to client section. In the client section, I will copy it from about. In the client section, then let's copy the import statements and paste. Instead of about, I will mention clients. Okay, client section is also done. Let's go to the next one. After clients, we'll go to gallery. Footer, not yet. Let's copy the import statements and in the gallery HTML we have gallery dot data dot it's not gallery images we have gallery blocks BLOCK blocks. Okay, save this. I think this is also done. After gallery, we'll go to the next component, header. Okay, in the header, we'll go to the component here. So now you see how convenient and easy it is now. Header, we'll go to header. Now the import statements. Save. Let's make changes to header component. Header data dot data. I hope you are able to follow. I'm just trying to keep it simple. Feel free to ask questions if you have. I'm not sure if we covered testimony, but about the service component. Okay, I'm not sure if the service component is there, but title, description, and detail. Let's check our data file service. Okay, service is there. So we'll go to about. We'll copy the statements, then we'll go to about again and paste services. And saving this one, so let's close services. Header we can close. So header is done, service is done, pricing. Let's do the pricing. So okay, pricing. The import statements. I know the kind of repeated activity we are doing, but this is exactly how things are to be done. Okay, pricing is also done. Let's make changes to the HTML file. So pricing dot data dot. So let's copy this. Okay, we are good with this. Now let's go back to our website. We have home working, about is working, gallery, services, testimonials, client, pricing. everything is working. Now let's convert this also to a component. Okay, let's generate a component. So ng generate component, and okay, two components. First one is footer, and second one is, ng generate component components is showing a merge conflict on path. Oh, footer component is already there. So show. Okay, so social component is created. So first let's complete the social. So we'll go back here. Footer component, how can I forget, is there. Let's complete this as well. So I will copy things from here. Footer component. Then the import statements. And instead of about, we will mention footer. I'm not sure why I was having this feeling that I missed to create this footer component, but now that we know we have it, let's work on this social component. Now in the social component, what we want is, we want, let's go to footer. So in the footer, going to HTML. Now this line of icons that we have, we want to remove it from here, and instead we will add app social. Okay. Okay. App social is not able to find because we have not imported. So we'll import. Import. App. Social component. Okay. Same social component I will mention here. So. Now app social is visible to this. Now in the social component, we will first make changes to the HTML. So this is what we want. We will repeat this @ for, now item is item of items. Instead of items, let's call it okay. Let this be as it is for now. Let's import the data first. So like we did in the other components, we'll copy it from here. We'll go to the TS file, and here it is, social and social. And then the import statements. Okay. So we have this variable now available. So let's go to the HTML. So we have item of social dot data. Let's look at the config service social. So here title is, this is social blocks. So name here is social blocks. So from social data, social blocks, drag item. Okay. Now we want to populate these. So this will be social dot social dot item dot target item dot title item dot URL and then one space for item dot username to make this URL unique for that user. Instead of Facebook, I need target dot icon. And this is again the title. So it is going to repeat this. And we have already used this in footer. And we will also use this in our navigation bar. So let's go to navigation bar and the HTML instead of these all. Let's add app social. Because app social is unknown to navbar, we'll add it to the component list. So let's add import social component and copy this in the import list. Okay, so we wanted to have to move data to a single file. We did that. We created a service and we used the service to wire up the data to the component. So task all completed for this particular video. Let's see how our website looks like now. Let me refresh. So we got home. Okay, let me open developer tools as well to see if there is an error. So there is no error. All these icons are working. And if I see, we have facebook.username, username, 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 behance.net username. Why is it not working? Let's see. Facebook, Google, Twitter. Twitter is now X. We should change that. Okay. And here. So now, next time, what you want to deploy is, now this is a good enough website as of now. So we have implemented this website. Everything is visible. Everything is working properly. And you can continue, and even if you want to, you can deploy such a website. All you have to do is, next time you want to make any changes to the data, you have to make changes to the configuration file. So you can go to, okay, let's close these unnecessary social files. So in configuration service, you want to change the username, you can change the username. Okay. Here the username is administer. So why is it not showing there? Okay, let's stop and create. It is showing feedback for testimonial data feedbacks track. Okay, now I know. We did make the changes initially, but if I go back to our code in the configuration file, let's go to feedback and the name here is feedback block. That is why it is not working. So in the testimony HTML feedback block, now it is fixed. should run without an error. Okay, we have an error. Duplicate identifier component services.component.html. It's not able to find the detail. Okay, let's go to services. Here we have services. We'll go to HTML. Okay, we never made changes here. Services dot data. I think we're good. No, not yet. We have clients.component.html. Clients component. Oh, how come we missed this one too? Data. Clients data. Clients. Okay, save. Do we still have error? Now it shows that duplicate identifier component. Okay, let's go back to our code. And I think while copying pasting, okay, about is single component inject testimonial. Let's close this configuration item. Okay, so about we have checked. Let's go to client. We'll go to client component.ts. We have component, there is no duplicate. Footer, we have component. No duplicate. Gallery, no duplicate. Header, no duplicate. Navigation, no duplicate. Pricing, component inject, no duplicate. Services, this is also good. Social. Oh, save. Oh, mention completed. We have our landing page. Home, about, gallery, services, testimonial, clients, pricing. Pricing is working. So we do not have clients, about gallery and clients. See, I thought I completed the video, but okay, let's quickly do this. About, we'll go to about and HTML, about data, title, description, detail. Okay, these icon blocks are not working. Okay, let's see if there is an error. There is no error. Okay, let's do a console print. console.log Icon blocks. Capital and small. So config service. Let's go to about. We have icon blocks all in small. And here in okay, this is also small. Why is it showing in capital? Okay, maybe let's stop this and create once again. So it is just the regeneration. I think there is a lot of caching which is happening. So let's look at the gallery and Sir clients also. We will go to gallery. In the gallery component, we have gallery blocks, gallery data, image.url. Okay, this is also good. Now configuration file, we have, oh, it's not able to find the gallery with capital G. Okay, let's go to client clients. Small little mistakes, but that's the fun of programming. Clients data, we have using clients, and here do we have, what do we have, client. So S, okay, so we're good. So it's already too late for me to sleep now, but okay, I'll leave you with this. And this is also showing correct usernames. So at times we have to stop serving and then restart the serve. Start the learning. So I'll upload this video, and I will also upload the code to my GitHub page, which is this github.com administrator. And all you have to do is change the video. So from website, video 1, video 2, video 3, and I will add video 4 here. So thank you for watching. I hope you have learned something along with me while doing this project. I wish you all the best and see you in the next video. See you. Bye-bye. Good night.